loss, to suffer a misfortune or a downturn or a loss of something that we hold dear to us, is one of the themes that you see in the Quran, that the Quran seeks to purify in us and to guide us in how to approach it. One of the most powerful examples is in Surah Al-Qasas. Imagine you are the mother of Musa alayhi salam. You've been seeing these visions over the last 9 months as you're carrying your child and he's growing within you. And you hear that Pharaoh has ordered that every first male born son is to be put to death. And after you have given birth, you've seen in your visions and in your night dreams to build a basket and to make it watertight. And if the soldiers come, to cast it into the river, and this child will come back to you and grow up to become a magnificent creature and worshiper of Allah, who will be a leader for your community. You've seen all of these things that have made your heart feel satisfied. And on that fateful day, as the soldiers of Pharaoh come to your home, hearing that you've given birth, you put him, after feeding him, into that basket, and you cast him into the river. In your mind, you believe that that river is going to whisk him away from Pharaoh, away from the soldiers, away from others. And lo and behold, the water carries him by the command of Allah to the footsteps of the wife of Pharaoh, la'anahullah. فَأَصْبَحَ فُؤَادُ أُمِّ مُوسَى فَارِغًا. Allah describes that moment. It is at that moment that the heart of Moses' mother became empty. She suffered the most complete loss. What have I done? How could I do this to my own son? How can I let this happen? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that I inspired in it. رَبَطْنَا عَلَىٰ قَلْبِهَا لِتَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. I tied down, fastened her heart with faith so that she reignited and retained her completion of faith. Subhanallah. At a moment of loss, it is a significant test where you ask Allah to give you stability and focus and nearness to Allah. And therefore, whenever you look into the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you will see that one of the consistent mentorship processes of Allah for him is through the loss of his valued members of his community and his society. I want you to imagine the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam burying 3 sons and 3 daughters, 6 children sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I want you to imagine that he didn't grow up with his father. He buried his mother. He buried his grandfather. He buried numerous uncles, Abu Talib, but more significantly Hamza radiallahu anhu in the Battle of Uhud. He lost and lost and lost, but all of it was gain. And therefore, in the context of the Quran, inna ma'al usr yusr, inna ma'al usr yusr, that when there is a straightening and when there is a collapsing upon you, when there is something that is squeezing you and loss has been suffered, know that an expanse is soon to come and ease will be provided. And for every one hardship, there will be 2 levels or more of ease and comfort to arrive. Yes, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam lost Hamza, but he gained the conquest of Mecca. Yes, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam lost his beloved Khadija radiallahu anha, but he was given the Ummahatul Mu'mineen, the mother of the believers, with Aisha radiallahu anha. Yes, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was driven out and forced to hijrah, but he was given the fath of Mecca and a return to Al-Madinah on his own terms, not as one outcast, but as one who is beloved and retained by the Ansar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to see our loss as the corner step to gain. May Allah allow us to open our hearts to the difficulties that we are in as a growth process to what we seek to attain and further in our dealings. May Allah allow those of us who have lost some of our wealth to regain it in our iman and in our homes and in our health and in our families and in our future prosperity. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow loss not to affect our iman and our tawakkul and reliance upon Allah. Allahumma ameen.